First of all, you got to get the dust cap off. If you're fortunate, you can get it off without destroying it. They kind of get dried in, dry rotted a little bit over time, and you almost have to buy new ones. But they're cheap, so that's not too big a deal. Then you snap off the C-clip, which I'd show you, but I lost my camera person, so I'm doing this by myself. There's a washer, and you can see this wheel's pretty messed up, the bearings are. So hopefully my spindle's not too bad. You can see the spindle's got some scoring to it, but since I'm replacing it with the bushings with bearings, I'm just going to go with it for now. If I need to replace it later, I'll have to, but we'll see how it goes. Alright, got to punch the old bushings out. You get your punch, pretty decent sized one, and then you find the lip of the bushing. Here's one out of the other wheel. You got to get on this lip here and punch it out that way, or you'll go through the side of the rim, which I did, so I can show you that later on. Oops. That one was pretty easy, actually. Sometimes that one first one I did. And the second one's easy to get out because you can look right in there and see it. And then they're both out. This one is in pretty bad shape. That's why the wheel is wobbling so much. Then you just want to clean the grease out of there and you know, clean the wheel up or whatever you're going to do, and then put the new bearings in. Okay, this is how not to do it. In the process of punching the bushings out, I guess I was being a little much, too much like a barbarian, and my punch started to move. I thought the bushing was coming out, and I punched it right through the side of the wheel hub. So, not ruined as far as being able to use it, but now I have a big hole in it, so I'll have to put some silicone there. So be careful when you're punching those out. Alright, putting the bearings in are pretty simple. You just put them back where the bushings came out. And the ones that John Deere sells, the AM127304s, seem to be pretty good quality ones. I've seen the cheap ones on eBay, and they don't seem like they're nearly as good a quality as these. These are about $30, not from the dealer, but from independent seller. But you find a socket that fits on the outer race roll nicely, like this one, and you just kind of tap it in until it seats all the way down. Do the same thing on the other side. And that's basically it. You just put the wheel back on the way you took it off. These are sealed bearings, so people may have differing opinions, but there's no reason to pack them with grease because they're already packed with grease. So if they ever wear out, I just take them out and throw new ones in, but they'll probably outlast the tractor, quite honestly.